We have new trailer, we have load from Amazon, and we are going to Germany. Today probably I will sleep at the Austrian border, and tomorrow we will have full day to drive around 400 kilometers. I have to sleep before crossing the border because in Austria there is a ban for driving. Like, you cannot drive a truck in Austria after 8 p.m. every single day. There is nothing what I can do about it. So let's just enjoy, you know? Maybe some music. I like this one. The only truck on this highway right now. I still have 280 kilometers. We are crossing into Lombardia. Almost 8 p.m. I guess around midnight I will arrive and I will go sleep for 9 hours, and tomorrow I will cross Austria. So yeah, I will record something because Austria is nice. Views are really, really nice, but I guess it's going to be cold. But for now, it's quite nice, 10 degrees, like almost no wind whatsoever. I'm just missing those stars on the sky, you know. There is some magic when you are driving and you can see all the stars and the moon, and that's life, you know, that's life. Update, so right now I have 150 kilometers to parking, and we are kind of surrounded by mountains. I can see shadows, you know, on the right and left. I think 1 hour 30 minutes and we should be there, maybe a bit more, because now mostly I will go uphill, but should be good. I mean, I still have plenty of time, like more than 2 hours, I think even more than 3 hours of driving. So you know what? I was passing few petrol stations with parking places for trucks, and it looked kinda full. Very hard to say what I will see at the end of this highway, because the parking I have picked is the last parking on this highway, and I'm really not sure if I will find a place there. I mean, it's the first day after Christmas, and during Christmas time, like, all parking places were like empty. But I don't know, it's very hard to say. I still have 120 kilometers there. I think that when I will have around 20-25, then I will just check every single place that would be possible to park, you know, petrol station or some parking or something. Because if I won't find a free place there, then I will have to like go back. It's not going to be good. Yeah, like even 25 kilometers from the border, it's not going to make a difference tomorrow. In Italy, on the highway, you have sometimes that kind of places, like you can see here on the right, this truck, you know, he's just, you know, standing here and maybe he's gonna sleep here. I mean, it's good to have those are here quite often, and it's good because when you're gonna run out of driving time, then you can use it. But I will tell you why it's shit to park in that kind of place or even close to main road. It's shit because then if car is passing, you know, close to you, or a truck or bus, whatever, your whole cabin is like wobbling, you know, on the sides, from one side to another. And the feeling is like you're on the boat. And for me personally, I hate boats. Just once I have parked in Czech Republic, in city, close to a main road. And it was hell of a night. I barely slept. And I said to myself, never again. I have 20 kilometers and right here will be some petrol station. 900 meters. It looks shit. I mean, maybe here. I don't know, maybe. I have no idea. Let's go a bit further. Does not look good. Shit. Quick decision. Are we going further or not? Shit. You know what? Let's go. Because this one place here is very close to the road. So let's go. Let's go and let's have hope. We have 18 kilometers to the last parking place. It will be automatic. And we are going. We are very close. Like basically 200 meters. It's somewhere here. It's tight. I mean, we have to park here. It's like last chance. Or I'm going to park here. Or I have to go back and find something. Where is this parking? I think here on the right. There are places. Yes, we'll find the place. We will. Yes. No problem. Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. But now, we have to reverse a bit. Because I have to make it smart. Because we are going to leave quite late, around 8:30, I guess. And most of those trucks will leave probably around 5 or 6. And I want to park here, like on the left of this blue truck. Yes, right here. We are going to fit nicely. Nice, nice. Nice. That's it. That's it. I'm done. I'm done for today. Good morning. It's just after 8 a.m. It's minus 2 degrees Celsius. We will check the trailer. That's a lot of snow. Shit, that's cold. But look at those views. Yeah, everything is fine. Everything is fine. Internet here is so bad that I cannot even check how far away is petrol station that I'm supposed to refill. But okay. Okay. We have time. I know that to Amazon from here we have around 400 kilometers. Okay, around 1 hour and we're gonna refill. I'm going to buy coffee and then we are going straight to Amazon. Slowly, slowly, because it's very tight. Like, I can barely fit in this lane. And we came back from this road yesterday. And 60 again. Shit. Nice. Oh, look at the left. Nice. I had to look on the road, but I want to look there. Ah. Nice. Imagine living there. I hope they have some shop, you know. That's a nice view on the city and those mountains far away there. I just saw the sign. It's seriously speed limit 40 for trucks. Damn. I mean, I can get 60, but 40? Okay, let's set 41 on cruise control and we can go. Oh, that's a nice view. God damn it. That's nice. Still going 40. That's a nice building there. Nice view probably. That's a nice view. God damn it. 54 kilometers to go. We are going for some kind of control. I don't know exactly what kind of control. I think they will check if we are not overloaded. I guess not. So maybe just, I don't know. But anyway, we are just passing by it. Okay, so 500 meters and we are going to turn right. Yeah. They have even a shower. That's nice. I don't need, but... You don't see showers so often, you know, driving in Europe. I mean, it depends from a country, but still. Okay, so we are on the road again. I have full tanks of AdBlue and diesel. Unfortunately, I don't have my coffee because they had some shit coffee machine. So I guess I will park, you know, in Germany already, because we have like 14 kilometers to our border, and I will buy my coffee somewhere. We are coming closer to this control. As you can see, just two lanes, and I don't know if they will check something. Let's see. So they let me go, but here you can see they are holding a Flixbus with people and some normal car. Okay, let's go to cruise control, 88 per hour. Germany, 299 kilometers to go. I have my coffee here, I took some extra sugar. We can go, we have 240 kilometers. 145 till Amazon. It's quite boring. I mean, driving in Germany is, roughly speaking, it's just boring, you know. It's just highway and fields, you know, forest, sometimes city, sometimes village, and that's it. That's it. I have 5 minutes, 4 kilometers, and I will reach Amazon, and I will see if they will unload or I have to wait. Maybe it will be possible to unload me before 1 a.m. You probably can't see shit. Here is my truck. I don't have trailer. I left trailer at Amazon. They will unload it, but I don't know when. I have parked on some road. There are like few trucks and I will go to shop. It's 8 minutes by foot. I'll do some shopping and at least 9 hours I have to wait. And now it's, what time is it? It's 5 p.m. So around 2 a.m. I will go to Amazon and maybe I will take the trailer, maybe not. So basically I have my trailer, it's 3 a.m. I'm at some parking spot and yeah, I will go sleep, and if there will be some work for the rest of the night, they will call me. If not, then they will call me during the morning. No one called. Friday, 9 a.m. It is 6:40 p.m. and our first destination is Amazon warehouse, like 135 kilometers away. We're gonna load there something and we will go close to border with Netherlands, around 550 kilometers. I have to be there tomorrow at 8 a.m. I think I can make it, like, no problem. So yes, update. I have my load from Amazon. We have 478 kilometers to go. This road is not easy. I'm basically all the time wrestling with the wind to keep this truck in the middle of this lane. 6 kilometers and we're gonna reach highway again. Now we are driving in kind of, you know, like normal roads. To city or forest. Okay, so I found some parking place and I have to take 45 minutes. Okay, so let's turn this shit off. Everything off. I'm already empty. It's 9 a.m. almost. And I'm going to some parking for trucks. I have there like 8 kilometers, 12 minutes, something like that. And I have already job for, I mean, not for tomorrow, but after New Year, you know, for Tuesday. I will go to Czech, no, to Czech Republic. With Amazon, obviously, with Amazon. But right now, I just want to find some place to park, and I'm going to sleep a bit, because I'm just wasted. So I have some place to park. It's basically exit from car park and petrol station, but it's good enough. I mean, it's good enough. So it's 4:20 p.m. I bought some stuff in the shop, and I guess, yeah, we still have around 2 hours of break, and then I will drive like 200 kilometers to a different parking spot, much closer to Amazon, for Tuesday, yeah. And I will wait there basically 2 days, so it's fine. I'm getting ready, 10 minutes, and I will start driving to my next parking for this weekend, and I hope I will find some place, because it doesn't look good here, you know? It doesn't look good here, but hopefully 200 kilometers later will be a bit better. I have my parking space. It's basically in the middle of the forest, close to the highway, but it's quiet. I mean, I don't mind passing cars, as you can see. It's quite empty too. There's some restaurant, and that's it. Basically nothing else. This restaurant has no Wi-Fi for customers. But anyway, I will just use my personal internet. There is even a toilet. Looks okay, you know, good enough for me. There's a mirror so I can cut my beard. I mean, for some of you it could seem like a low quality, low standard toilet, you know, but it all depends from country that you are living in. I was living in 5 or 6 countries in Europe. I guess I will make some food and I will just chill out. Another day. It's after 2 p.m. I woke up recently, just taking a walk. It's not so cold, but a bit rainy. I have to switch myself, you know, to wake up as late as possible, because on Tuesday, oh, there's a guy from Finland, because on Tuesday I will have to start driving around 6 p.m. and I will drive a whole night. So I'm just sitting here making a video from Italy, and from this van you can see a lady is there, and she just asked me, you know, and those drivers here, if I need some food for free, because she has bread, you know, and so on, salad and some other stuff, but I have plenty of food, so I was like, I'm fine, yeah, but maybe other guys, you know, they need. So that's quite nice during last day of this year, 2023. It was a shitty year, you know, in many ways, but it is how it is. We have to live on. We have to live on. We have to get up, be a man, and push forward. Believe me or not, but this is the weirdest last day of the year I ever had. Look, two guys came here, one is running, and they gave me Bible in Polish language, my native language. It's like, it's new. And they gave me a pen drive with Bible as audiobook to listen. That's wild. But okay, I mean, it's nice, yeah, it's nice.